Hey guys, it's Aurelia Baker. I was high bar squatting for so long, and I finally made the change at the start of this year to be low bar, and what my experience was like using wraps. Before I got into powerlifting, obviously I was a high bar squatter. I didn't know any different. That's just squatting. I didn't know there was variations in squat, but I've only done front squats. So that's what I was used to. And so when I got into training with powerlifters and stuff like that, all they really told me was to have the bar lower on my back and to sit back in a sense. And this didn't really work for me. Didn't feel that good. Like the weight was okay when it was light in that sort of motion. And yeah, it just didn't feel very good. I tried. It just wasn't going to happen. So then that's why I just decided to stay high bar, because that's something I was used to. I was doing it for nearly 3 years. And I wasn't really told much information between the two different, like, I wasn't told that there was a difference between high bar and low bar, that your body's in different angles and all that kind of stuff. And so yeah, so then I was just persistent and I just pushed through being high bar squatter for so long. And I just thought my body wasn't designed to be a low bar squatter. I just thought because I have minor scoliosis, that maybe that might have something to do with me not being able to perform the low bar squatting. And obviously all my lips still going to get stronger anyway, so even though it wasn't the most effective way to squat, I was still going to get stronger anyway. So like my best high bar squat was 145, and just like how slow it was out of the hole. Like that was the worst thing about high bar, is just not having any of that like real stretch reflex out of the hole. That's what's hurting my squat the most. And that, because when you watch it, when I come out of the hole, as soon as I get out of the hole and start moving, it just goes, it just keeps going faster and faster. And where I think, you know, it should be more of a constant speed, not a slow then let's go fast sort of light on, like doing a lot of pause squats and all that kind of stuff, just trying to build so much strength out of the hole, because it was just such a weak spot being a high bar and sitting back. Because I feel like sitting back isn't always the best cue either. And that, because I feel that maybe just not as tight, because that's not what I do now. How I low bar squat now and how I kind of was showing is completely different. Like, so much different than, yeah, I was never going to feel comfortable doing it the way I was showing. And that's it. Even though you might train with powerlifters, stuff doesn't mean they know everything. All the stuff that I got taught this year was from the internet, just watching other people, how they live and how they perform the lifts, and just trying it for myself. So I got my maxes down and just tried. And so I looked at all the different ways of low bar squatting, and we found that me having my head down and having more of like neutral spine or whatever, I don't know what the terminology is, whatever, and stuff like that, and also wearing squat shoes, more for just keeping your hips, keeping my knees out in the squat as well. All this evidence to trying to be a low bar squatter, I wanted to make sure I did it perfect. I do like the UPA comp, it wasn't a very big comp, obviously it was just in my hometown, but that comp was just to see where my squat was at, to see, like, my ultimate goal was always to get 150 kilo squat. That was like the biggest, like I couldn't think of anything bigger than that to get that number. Just because of being a high bar squatter, it just seemed so limited. Like I was limited to how far I could really go with that. So I made sure I did like 10 kilo jumps, so I did 140, 150. And I didn't want to just go 155, because it's like, you know, I might as well try it all out, and I think, you know, you could tell when training that it was easier, but I was still getting similar reps to what I was the year before with high bar. So I didn't know like how much of a difference of the carryover would be. So I went 160 and it came up. And like the whole time I was doing it, it was just such a weird sensation. It just kept going up. I had no problem getting out of the hole. It's just like, phew, just went straight up. And I might as well just go for a fourth attempt, just for, you know, fun. I'm here, might as well do it. So I decided I'll just go 5 kilos more. And I didn't, and I ended up doing 165, and I was just so blown. At that time, I was planning to do Pro Raw in November. Which I obviously wanted to learn to use wraps. And I never really tried using wraps that much before because, like I said, ages ago, using wraps when I was doing a high part just felt really shit. Because when I started them light, got used to the sensation, made them a little bit tighter, and like they weren't that bad. Still have to be strong to begin with, and then you have to learn how to use them to make sure you can get what you're meant to get out of them. When I went to do the GPC comp in August, I didn't want to do wraps for that comp because I wanted to perfect using the mono since I didn't have access to a mono anymore, and needed to learn how to use the mono on the day of the competition because all the other comps I've always walked out because that's just what I've always done. Using the mono, it did change my squat just a little bit. I think it was how I normally squat. Is it probably had my hips a bit too far back a little bit. So when I use the mono, my hips don't go back as far when I unlock it. Yeah, so I took that on board of the slight different sensation that it gave me and then adapt that into my then my training as well. So it's so funny because having to use, obviously, wraps, you're going to have to do more weight and stuff like that. So like getting closer and closer to pro, I was dying to use a mono. Because it's just getting so hard to walk out, just because it's heavy and effort. I found it more tiresome to walk out than doing the working. Especially when I did like the 160 and the 170. I was really freaking taxing. Like, just even just for those two sessions to have a mono would have been nice. But it's not like it's end all. Like, it doesn't really matter. I still got the training sessions done. Still did a great comp. I'm so glad. Like, I'm not sad that I didn't do low bar in the following years, before this year and stuff, but because I still managed to keep up with everyone last year, roughly total wise and all that kind of stuff. But I'm really glad that I did make the change this year because everyone just keeps getting so freaking strong. I kind of needed all that extra weight on my squat to just keep me up, especially because my stupid bench doesn't seem to go anywhere. Now that I'm low bar gives me heaps of pop-out help. Now that I can use wraps, that gives you even more pop-out help. So now that I have all this pop-out of the hole, it just flows straight back up. And high bar, I had none of this popping business out of the hole, and I had all this strength at the top half. Like, if I was going to fail a squat at high bar, it was going to be in the hole. Now, it's probably, well, I've only actually failed really one squat low bar, and that's when I came halfway up, and I think that was just more fatigue and all that shit. So, yeah, I hope this was helpful. Talk to you again soon.